Hello everyone, Genesis Rider here with my gameplay review, episode 10. We're going to be taking a look at some of Sinecure 53's Regicide Haven gameplay. This is his second submission. His first didn't meet my qualifications, but this second one definitely does. Let's go over his loadout very briefly here. He's using the battle rifle, magnum, as well as stealth, frag grenades, and sentry turret along with mobility. Now I know this loadout is not well suited for free-for-all or small regicide flavored maps, but we'll go over that at the end of the video. So to start off, I'm going to say that this gameplay is not extremely high level, but he specifically wants to know, I want to learn how to finish off close regicide games. I can't begin to tell you how many second place finishes I've had. Those are direct words from his submission comment. Now, I can definitely help you with this, Sinecure 53. So let's go over your film step by step. It's only 6 minutes long, but this video will be a rather lengthy one due to the amount of technical errors you do make. So let's just go over your gameplay in general, and I'll round it out with some overall tips for Regicide more towards the end. So to start off here, you have a really good beginning gameplay here. You start off putting some really solid sauce into this guy, zooming as you should. Your first grenade goes a little off, let's ignore that. Your second grenade hits this player very well, and you get the headshot. You end up laying down your sentry turret in one of the most clutch predicted sentry turret placedowns I've ever seen. You then bounce back, bouncing away from that grenade there, and let your sentry turret clean up this guy. Now, for those of you who are unaware, the sentry turret takes 4 shots to the body to kill an unshielded Spartan, which is what this sentry turret did. The sentry turret does fire very quickly, but another thing you should notice about the sentry turret is that it only fires at targets that are, in general, in front of it. It will not actually turn around in midair and fire at targets that are behind it. That is not the purpose of the sentry turret. It only fires at targets within about this angle right here, from here to here. That's about. It's not 180 degrees in front of it like some people think. Now, it is puzzling to me after you get this kill that you walk over here because that kill did pop up. So you come up here and you're a little bit hesitant approaching top middle. And I want to address this, okay? You're waiting for people to come into your sight range. You need to be pushing up very, very quickly here. This is Regicide. You don't have time to screw around, much less slowly push up here. Now, if you're waiting for your shield to regenerate or reload, that's different, but neither of which were you doing here, okay? You need to jump up onto this platform to get an angle on opponents. And once you begin firing at this person, specifically jump up on this platform angle so that this guy won't be able to get around top middle and get away from you, because you'll have a slight edge on him and be able to work around top middle and get more angles on that so he can't get away. As it is, you kind of wait for him to sort of make his move, and you do end up picking the headshot up there, which is good. You drop down for this player, as you should, but unfortunately you don't seem to know which target to shoot at, and this is really unfortunate overall because that other player was completely unaware as you drop and literally ran across the field of vision. But I want to point out something here. This yellow player is using the assault rifle. And what he is going to try to do is close the distance between him and you, okay? And that is what you want to be doing when you have your assault rifle out. Because the assault rifle, if you are not already aware, when you're shooting it, your reticle blooms, or the center of your reticle blooms outward, becoming bigger and bigger and bigger, which means that the more you hold down the trigger while using the assault rifle, the less accurate your bullets are. Now, if you release the trigger, the reticle goes back to being its normal self in the center, but the battle rifle never blooms, okay, which is really nice. So what the enemy player is going to be trying to do is get closer and closer and closer to you, closing that distance between him and you so that the bloom does not affect his shots. Now, I realize you are kind of hit by a grenade here, and there's not much you could have done about this death specifically, but you need to be backing away and specifically moving from side to side away as you back away from this player. So specifically, time your BR shots as your reticle goes over the enemy player. So you're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4 as you back away, okay? Making it harder for him to kill you and making it so that your shots land as you pull the trigger moving from side to side. This is one of the best ways to counter an assault rifle player charging dead at you. So as it is, this guy cleans you up pretty well. The king comes up from behind you, and you get the assist on that player. Now, once again, you're being extremely passive here, okay? And I want to zoom forward here to this moment when you notice that this guy is right here. Do not stand still right here. you need to be crouching and moving to the right. If you had crouched and moved to the right here, when this player came around the corner, right here, when he comes around the corner and is going to be looking at you, he won't be able to see you if you had crouched and moved a little bit up this ramp, okay? Because you would have moved yourself, and he would have come around the corner and gone, wait, what the heck? And he would run over here, and you would still be crouch walking, preferably, and you'd be behind this pillar. And then he'd conclude, oh, you're not there, and then walk up open ramp and then go, oh, what the heck, as you pop up from around the corner and start firing him from behind. As it is, you do play this pretty well, but you could have played this better. As he comes around the corner, immediately knows you're there, switches to his alternate weapon, which he should, and you do end up coming out of him. You play this very, very passively, though. Solid shots, but you need to pick up the sniper rifle. And this is something I should have mentioned even earlier in the film, when you did not pick up the sniper rifle here, okay? And I want to say something to you right now. If you are not picking up the sniper rifle, someone else is. And that someone else is likely to use it more effectively than you are. Most specifically, don't pick up the sniper rifle because you are good at it or because you feel that you're going to be forced to use it. Pick up the sniper rifle so that other people don't get it, okay? The weapons despawn in Halo 4 off the map, and specifically this weapon that drops on the ground will despawn very shortly after this player dies. It despawns so fast that you can prevent other people from having the sniper rifle and getting kills with it. Don't feel that you must use it, and most specifically, don't feel that you have to get headshots with the sniper rifle to get kills. I have many, many a Haven gameplay where I will just body shot the living crud out of people and just clean them up with my secondary weapon or my battle rifle. You can feel free to do that as well, and don't try to get no scopes all the time. It's a bad idea in free-for-all. As it is, you don't grab the sniper, so I'm not going to address that too much. An unfortunate grenade right here by you. Okay turret placement, I would have liked to have seen you back a little bit down the ramp before you place that turret, or even jump on top of this platform and lay it down in this corner right here. As it is, it's an okay turret placement, but you end up sort of hanging back here way too much. Once again, remaining a little too passive. You do get the double kill, which is nice, and you notice eventually that these players are below you. Now right here, once again, you remain too passive, and I'm not saying this just because the guy is going to come up and assault rifle you from behind and kill you. When you see the king like this, who is focused on an enemy player, you need to immediately drop and try to kill him. Most specifically right here, you could drop on top of him and melee him before this enemy player gets the kill, I feel like, okay? As it is, you end up being cleaned up from behind. You get an excellent respawn on closed ramp, just to give you an idea. This is closed ramp because this area is closed off. The other area that you spawned on is called open ramp because it's very open. You see how it's open to the air and everything. So you end up killing the king here, and this is a really unfortunate series of events as you lay down a really good turret placement right here, but you fail to realize that an easy escape from this and a very preferable maneuver would just be to back up here, jump on top of this ramp, and let your turret engage this enemy player. By the time you do this, the enemy player will be almost out of ammunition and will be forced to either reload or switch to their secondary to clean up your turret. Okay? I'm calling it the turret. It's actually a sentry turret. But that is not what you do. Instead, you take the long way backing up, allowing the player to remain in eye contact with you or visual sight range with you, then back up the long way to the right, still letting the player maintain sight range with you, and by that time the player kills you. You could have jumped up here, and yes, you would have had low shields by that point, but you could have waited a few seconds for your turret to get a few more shots in, drop down here, and I guarantee you that player would have been mostly weak by that point, especially if you had fired at least one shot as you had jumped up here at the enemy player. Could have dropped down here and easily shot this guy in the head as he was cleaning up your turret. As it is, you don't do that. You end up throwing two wasted grenades, and this guy gains the kingship. Now, right here, it is important to note that while your second grenade is good, it is worthy to note that on the enemy player's standpoint, notice how that turret did not shoot at Sinecure 53. Okay, or yourself, should I say, because I'm addressing you, Sinecure, because it was facing this direction. It's not 180-degree angle of viewpoint. It's only generally in front. I'd say it's like 100 or 130 or 140 degrees of viewing angle in front of the sentry turret. Now, you could not have predicted this. This player actually jetpacked from top, middle, and assault rifled you from behind. He's using that strategy pretty well, able to surprise people like that. Now you end up shooting this player pretty well, and I want to point out that this first grenade, while pretty good, this second grenade is not going to go where you think it's going to go. Now, optimally, you would want to actually throw the first grenade like you did here, back up into this corner, and then throw the grenade off of this wall so that it bounces literally into the feet of this player, most likely killing him. Okay? As it is, you throw an okay grenade, but the grenade you needed to place would have been from standing here and throwing it right here so that it would have bounced right here. And this would only have killed him if he had actually charged out from his position around the corner. I want to show you what this grenade does. At its current angle of trajectory, it looks like your grenade is going to bounce into the corner and go dead, because you can see this little ledge sticking out. But that's not what it's going to do. I want you to notice how the grenade literally bounces past this ledge as if it's just a flat surface and goes past. There are many ledges like this in Halo. Walls that look like they have a ledge sticking out from them often become flat surfaces when you're throwing grenades at them. Now, I'm not saying this is a completely flat surface. I'm just saying that you got it insanely close to that ledge without actually hitting it. And this grenade is going to go wildly off, completely past this enemy player. Now, you do end up getting this kill, but it is important to understand that throwing grenades at angles like this, it's better just to get into a safer position and then throw a better angled grenade off of this wall. Or correct that grenade that you just, the second grenade that you threw there. Now, you do switch to the assault rifle, kind of a questionable play, but you do end up getting another kill here, so I'm not going to harp too much on that. I would have gone for this player's concussion rifle. I feel that this turret laydown is okay. I would have backed up here, okay? I would have backed up right here and then laid down your turret, grabbed the concussion, and then jumped up on top of here to gain a slight height advantage, and concussion rifle the living heck out of the person that's going to charge at you. As it is, you're kind of swarmed by these players, and you get killed from behind, and that strategy may not have worked for you even then. Once again, it is really unfortunate how you pursue this player who has the assault rifle. You end up kind of backing up here, but as soon as this player starts shooting you, as soon as he starts shooting you, which you should be aware he has the assault rifle, and this just comes with experience, you should back up around, just literally go straight to your right around this corner, back up and hurl a grenade, literally look down like this. With your player, do this. Back up to the right, look down at the ground, literally like this, and throw a grenade. He's going to come charging around the corner because, like I said, you have to close your distance with the assault rifle. He's going to come charging around the corner, get bold-faced with a grenade, and then he's just going to get cleaned up with a headshot if you're accurate. As it is, you do kind of get some shots on him, but you don't even get all of his shields down. I feel like you could have done a better job there engaging that player. You again rush bottom mid trying to take out this player. It's okay because you know where this guy is, but I would suggest that you go top middle. There's more targets that way, and it's more of a power position. Good pre-nade here, though. However, you do end up being cleaned up very quickly, and you don't do much of an effort trying to maneuver away from that grenade. Now, at this point, I'd like to point out a little bit of my thoughts on Regicide. I know it's not halfway through the game yet, but I'm going to briefly mention this. You seem to not understand that going for the king is really, really important. And there's a few points, not the specific one that just happened there, because you did go for the king. But once the king sort of dies, you kind of don't understand how to get to the king very quickly. Right here, what I would have immediately done is walk forward, jump onto this ledge, and then jump, and then crouch all the way up to this ledge, and crouch jump up to top middle, and then immediately go after the king, okay? Because you are behind the king, and it is important that you take him out for the extra 10 points of score he's going to give you. As it is, you kind of head in the king's general direction, but you take the long way, and you're not really fully aware of how to get up to him. If you had jumped up to the top and you had rounded this corner, okay, let's say that you had gone up top here and you had come around here and you had rounded this corner. This player is shooting and engaging with other people, and you would have been able to clean up at least one pretty easy kill here. Again, the king dies and you still haven't gotten a kill, and there's no point in throwing a grenade up this lift because it's always just going to explode at the top. The reason being, the bounce takes place in the middle of the lift. Okay, notice how when you throw grenades off of the surface, they explode earlier, which is why earlier I said to throw the grenade at the ground, because it would have exploded earlier in the player's face. When you throw a grenade into a lift, that bounce is taken by the lift, and it explodes earlier just like it would have if you had bounced the grenade. It's important to understand that, as it is here, you come up this lift and you're kind of unaware here. You are taken out by multiple people, but you're turning very slowly. I'm not sure what your sensitivity is. If you're playing on something less than 3, I would suggest making sure it's 3 or above. Most pro players find their sensitivity between 3 and 5. I'm not suggesting you change your sensitivity. I'm just mentioning that if you're playing 1 or 2, that's probably a bad idea. You, once again, throw 2 of your grenades. Your first grenade doesn't hit anything. That's kind of happened several times during the film. And your turret lay down here is not preferable, okay? And that the reason is, you need to lay down your turret as a precautionary measure when you're being pursued by a player and trying to gain your shield. This works best on ramps or on areas where you're coming around the corner. For example, here, you could come around the corner here, lay down a turret, and then back further back. As the player tries to get you, your turret will shoot them, and the player will be forced to either engage your turret or take damage as they continue to pursue you. Lay the turret down and then retreat. Don't lay your turret down and then run straight forward, because your turret is not going to end up doing a whole lot of good. Now right here, your turret does get off a few shots on this player, but as it is, that player lifts top middle, and this player has a brand new shield who you're shooting at and doesn't incur any shots from your auto sentry. I would like to point out here that this is not the range you should be using your assault rifle. I feel like you were a little bit gleeful after picking up that kill with the assault rifle on the concussion rifle pickup player right here, and you decided that, oh, I can get an assault rifle kill from this distance. Well, you just got proved wrong, as this player knows what to do and ends up backing away from you, as he should, and BRing you. What this player does to you is exactly what you should have done to that player earlier on. Granted, your incurrences with the assault rifle player so far have been much more difficult to counter than the assault rifle incurrence that foot-long curve 9 right here, who you're facing, incurs against you, because he's much farther away from you. He ends up cleaning you up with a nice headshot here, and you're going to spawn closed ramp. Now, you again have this tendency to pursue players who you know their location. So you look for this player and go, okay, he's bottom blue straight, and he just lifted top middle. But your focus should not be on the player who just killed you. You're in general, during, I'd say the majority, not all, but the majority of this gameplay, you're playing it as if you're playing a normal free-for-all game. Looking at the player who just killed you to see if they're weak, and then clean them up, which is very possible to do in Halo 4 because of the quick and terrible respawns. So, as it is, in general, rule of thumb is that you should be moving towards the king throughout the majority of your gameplay, unless you feel comfortable maintaining a second position lead and no one else on the scoreboard is even remotely close to contesting you for that second place lead. You can remain second place and then at the very sort of end, get first place and win the game. As it is, you are in fourth place and you cannot afford to do that. You need to be, in general, heading towards the king at all times, but you become easily distracted. You get a good kill here and you also get a really good grenade here, but I would immediately pursue this kill, and you do. You're going top middle, but again, you're kind of hanging back. You're kind of inching forward. Oop. You need to be going forward and attacking these players. Again, not just running at a dead sprint at them, but moving towards your target, being aggressive. A nice turret lay down here, but I would have liked to have seen you angle yourself a little bit to the left here so that if players lifted up on this lift, the turret would be able to shoot at them. Now, it is nice because your turret lands some key shots on the enemy king, but you would have gotten the assist here anyway because the king drops bottom middle. I would like to point out to all of you players who are not familiar, when you get an assist on the king at Regicide, you get 5 points towards your actual score in the game, okay? This is extremely crucial, and a lot of players don't know this, all right? That this is one of the many, many reasons I say go after the king and in general move towards the king, because even if you don't kill the king, you can get an assist from a grenade or a random shot, or as is the case here, an auto sentry place down. I would also like to point out that you end up reloading here, okay? As the king comes to top middle from top mohawk, you end up reloading as this player obviously crosses your path. The battle rifle has the capability to take out 3 fully shielded Spartans with 1 clip. That is, if you are 100% accurate, and as long as your 4th shot is a headshot. As it is, there's no need to reload here, and this player is mildly weak from your auto sentry already. You could turn and shoot this player in the back and kill him, and then possibly pursue this other player, okay? As it is, you reload and this wastes precious seconds of time. I would definitely recommend loading out with the dexterity perk to help you curb this. But there's a contradictory note to that, which I will say at the end of this film. So let's move forward here. You see the king, and you just suddenly decide, okay, I'm going to drop and follow him. And once again, this turning of your camera, you come here to this side, go hup, 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 turn your camera, hup, and then drop. No, there's no need to do that. You need to be walking forward, turn around, and literally go down as you're doing this. This needs to be one fluid motion, saving you a few seconds of time. You get some nice shots into the king here. You get the regicide. The sniper is up. Would have liked to have seen you have gone for that. But as it is, this is a really crucial mistake you make here. And it's probably best that you didn't go for the sniper rifle overall, so I won't harp too much on that. You sprint here. There is literally no need to sprint whatsoever. And there are several things you end up doing wrong here. The number one thing that you end up doing is sprinting, and then the second thing you end up doing is panic grenading. What this is when you're about to die, you throw a grenade. When people stick you while panic grenading, it's called a noob stick in my book, because it's just extremely noobish. It's a last resort, and people get insanely lucky in my experience with sticking people right as they're about to die. So you're coming around the corner here, and you don't need to sprint. You just need to walk forward as close to this corner as possible to cut off this angle to this player who's shooting you behind you as fast as possible. Come around this corner, jump as you did, and immediately begin BRing this kid. Okay? I want to show you how weak this guy was. Okay? If you had just been able to put a few shots into this player, you would have been able to kill him with two shots. Now, as it is, this player throws down a pretty good grenade, and you are being shot in the back. So once again, I'm not quite sure if you could have managed this, but I feel that if you had done all three things, cutting off the angle quickly, not sprinting, and immediately shooting instead of grenading, I think if you would have pulled out this kill for 20 points, okay, you end up, panic grenading, and that's not a really good idea. You're spawning on blue ramp, and you rush immediately bottom middle, only to have the king taken out, and you should have known that the king was going to be taken out here. I, again, would have gone top middle. You're spending way too much time on the bottom of the map. Once again, there are two players above you who, if you had known that, okay, the king's probably going to die, which he immediately did, you could have just pushed up here and immediately begin shooting these players. Oh, by the way, three players up here. You could have been taking them out, possibly even getting a sword out of that. Now, you do find this player bottom street, and he thruster packs. This is exactly the reason why you never thruster pack in the middle of a duel, unless you are far away from the player and you're thruster packing butt or back behind cover. Now right here, I would lift top middle or lift to the top of the street. You lift top middle, which is probably a good idea, seeing as this player behind you knows you're there on the radar and is likely looking for you to lift up. So you lift up top middle and you miss the king just by a hair again. You end up going for this kill again, and you don't recognize that the king is lifted up on you, and that you end up embarrassingly being taken out. Again, it's very crucial to keep in mind where the king is, and you come off this respawn with a good mindset of taking out the king, and I like what you do here. You fire some shots immediately across the map, and this is one of the reasons why I don't like Regicide, as the king ends up literally spawning behind you. And I would like to point out here a positive note out of all of this, okay? While it is extremely unfortunate that the king does spawn behind you, and incredibly unfair, this is one of the only times when you lay down your turret in the middle of a battle. And even then, I'm going to give you the benefit of the doubt and say that you did not even know this player was behind you when you lay down your turret. Now, I would like to point out, just below your BR scope on the right-hand side of the screen, it is pretty obvious to tell that the bounty, the king, is behind you. Okay, but I'm going to say that you didn't recognize this, that you're not a fast-paced, quick eyes enough of a player to notice this right off the bat, and that you laid down your turret out of just wanting to lay down your turret in a good position. So far, you have used the Promethean turret in much better of a way than I've seen other players use it. And while I don't encourage its use for free-for-all, I would like to stop here a note that you have some experience with this armor ability. No doubt, hands down. Unfortunately, you end up being cleaned up by the king here, and your turret doesn't end up doing much good. And I would like to point out also that the Promethean turret uses up energy not only after after just staying on the field, just by staying on the field. But the Promethean turret also uses up energy by being shot at, and it dies very quickly. But it also uses up energy by shooting at enemy players, making it not last very long. Now right here, the king is top middle. You end up throwing a pretty good grenade on this player, and this player also does grenade you. An unfortunate lag happens here. Now, this is once again a very important situation to come across here. And this is literally what I would have done. Right here, I see the king right here. But then I immediately see that this player has spawned across from you. The first thing I would do is come right here and grenade right into the middle of this platform. Then I would keep my position behind this column here, okay? Because I don't know what the king is going to do, okay? Once you see that the king is going to engage here, the king comes across from top middle, what you're likely to see is that the king will pursue this player because he sees him on his radar. As the king is coming across here, it's likely that he, if you don't hear any shots from up here, which is, again, a good use of a surround sound headset if you have one, he's going to see this guy and go immediately after him. Now, as it is, the king goes after you because you're the most weak, and this player goes behind this column, so the king can't really see this player very well, so the king's going to go after you. But as it is, if you had remained behind cover here, it's okay if the king kills this player. But it is not okay for him to kill you. You need to kill the king, because by killing the king, you're going to get two kills. You can give up this kill. This kill doesn't matter when the king is coming at you like this. And again, you can keep track of the king kind of out of the corner of your eye using that little bounty waypoint, as you can see just above the sword icon on the left side of your screen here. As it is, the king once again ends up cleaning you up, and I would have liked to see you try to ninja here. Ninjing, you would have jumped kind of towards the king and looked down and tried to melee him in the back as he came towards you. That would have been a sick ninja, but that's an advanced maneuver. I don't expect you to pull that off, and it don't take away any points for that for sure in my mindset. Right here, you do some really good grenades, looking for the king. They explode on the king, and you throw down your Promethean turret. Now, this is an unfortunate placement of your Promethean turret, I feel like, because you could have jumped here and pursued the king trying to get that kill. I feel like the king stayed alive long enough for you to try to get that kill. But as it is, it's a pretty good laydown on your Promethean turret, and you end up getting this headshot on this player. Now you got a guy pursuing you from behind, so you're going to push up, which is good. This is the kind of sort of aggressive nature I like to see from players. Now, it would be nice if you had dropped down here and sort of, basically reloaded. I don't understand. You have to maintain passivity and aggressiveness. You need to be aggressive when you have a full clip and full shield. Then you need to be immediately passive, dropping down to open ramp here and sort of remaining alive. If this player pushes up on you on your radar, drop down here. If the player drops down after you, come behind this little pillar. If the player pursues you behind this little pillar, start playing Ring Around the Rosie with him. You always have to have a second option for staying alive. And right here, I don't even feel like you tried to pursue even one of your options. Now, it is coming down to a very tight game. I'd like to point out the score right here. You are only 15 points behind this enemy king, and you're going to get a pretty good shots on him, getting the king assist. Unfortunately, again, getting 5 more points, you're now tying him for the lead, and you did kill an enemy player there as well, getting 15 points to tie the king for the lead. Now, you don't become the king until you've actually gained the lead, but the king just got another kill, so you're going to have to get 10 more points or more to get the kingship. Now you end up trading for the assault rifle again, and I don't think that's truly necessary. You lay down an okay Promethean turret, but I'm not exactly sure why you do, as the only person on your radar is this guy behind you. But I do think that you realize that you need to go after the king, because he only has 5 points until he wins the game. So that's what you end up trying to do. But as it is, when this king respawns, you take way too long to turn around and try to find him. I really like this pick-off shot you do perform here, though. I feel like you would have been able to get to the king faster had you not picked up the assault rifle and had you turned around once you had seen the king respawn. Once you saw that the king was to your right as you were charging top Mohawk, you should have immediately turned around completely and gone top middle. Why is that? Because it is insanely likely that the king has spawned on this ramp. 4 main spawn points on Haven, blue ramp, closed ramp, red ramp, and open ramp. Now, there are other spawn points, don't get me wrong, but those are the most common. So as soon as you are charging top Mohawk, you should have gone, hey, he's likely to spawn on that ramp because I see the indicator for the king appear on my right-hand side. This means he's either open ramp directly behind me, so I'm going to have to turn around anyway, or he's on this ramp. And what's the most common thing for people to do when they spawn on the side ramps? Rush top middle, which is exactly what this player does. Now, you do get a great pickoff shot here, but you cannot depend on this player backing up like this. But again, great pickoff shot here for the Regicide to tie the lead once again. You only need 5 more points, and you pick up that kill with the assault rifle. Really good job here maintaining under pressure that very last kill. Now, this was a good gameplay overall. I would have liked to seen you have used a different loadout, however, and I'm going to go over this, all right? And for those of you who are not interested in the loadout, that's the end of this video. If you want to submit your own gameplay to me, for me to review, click on the annotation in the top right-hand corner or click on the first link in the description. That will take you to the video where you can submit your own gameplay in the comments section. Please watch that video all the way through to know exactly what kind of films I'm looking for and how to make your submission in the comments section of that video as preferable as possible for me to review it. Now, moving back to Sinecure 53, your loadout, BR Magnum Mobility, Self-Frags, and Sentry Turret. You need to try to use the thruster pack or maybe even the jet pack in free-for-all. The reason why I say that is that thruster pack is going to save you far more than a Promethean turret will. As it is, use what you like to. If you want to be unique in free-for-all, and if you're not gunning for a 50 CSR in free-for-all or anything like that, feel free to use a sentry turret. I like your placement with that. As it is, the stealth perk, which you're using, that allows you to stay off of people's Promethean vision, specifically when you're not moving. Okay, it also allows you to assassination animate players more quickly, and it allows you to switch weapons more quickly. Now, these are useful traits, but not nearly as useful as some of the other things you could be using. But before we move to those things, I want to also mention that you're using mobility. There is almost no need to use mobility on this map. Seeing it as it is free-for-all, you're going to come across players very, very quickly. And if you don't come across players and you're sprinting for the king, you're going to get killed very quickly by those other players who are going to be focusing in on your location. There's no need to use mobility on the majority of the maps in free-for-all. Instead, I would highly recommend using shielding, which will allow your shields, once they have started regenerating, it will allow your shields to regenerate more quickly. This will allow you to get back into the fray easier and be a more aggressive overall more quickly. I would also recommend trading your stealth perk for dexterity, because it feels like overall that would be more useful for you. Or you could trade it for ammo so that you don't run out of ammo. As it is in free-for-all, you die so much that I would just trade it for dexterity to allow you to reload faster. Again, allowing you to be more aggressive with your play style. Again, that's just my opinions. You can do whatever you want to. That's just how I would view it. If you're playing on a drift when an enemy team player is using the sniper, having the stealth perk can be very useful if that player is using Promethean vision, as it is a nightmare to get sniped by someone using Promethean vision on maps with long hallways. As it is, Sinecure 53, thank you for submitting this film. I really enjoyed it, and I hope these tips give you an idea of how to play Haven Free For All better and just general tips overall. Thank you guys for watching this gameplay review, and I'll see you guys in the next capture or whatever end of recording. Peace.